Hey there, and welcome back to the Train of Thought, an educational monster train series where we fight the divinity in every run. So I've been on a real avocado toast kick lately. I've always loved breakfast foods so much, just all sorts of breakfast stuff. I could eat it for every meal. I'm also that kind of crazy person who still, despite my age, continues to love things like cereal. So there's just whatever goes into breakfast foods, it's like just so addictive for me. It's not even like sugar. I actually prefer savory. I don't enjoy sugary breakfasts. So I know what you're immediately thinking is like, pancakes, waffles, and things like that. No. Now, maybe there is like once in a while I like a Belgian waffle, but at the same time, I'm not a big fan of sugary or sweet things, especially in the morning. I just don't really get it. But so for me, it's been avocado toast with red pepper flakes and lemon. And this has just been like on like a really nice like whole grain bread with like the whole thing. It's so good. I'm a huge fan of it. And that's been my recent kick. Pretty much every single piece of corporate travel or any kind of visiting anywhere that has a breakfast location, anything I've done like that recently, I've always found out the places that have good breakfasts. It's a nice thing if they also have like a nice coffee or something. I'm always a big fan of those little breakfast joints. So why do I bring it up? I don't know. What's your favorite breakfast food? That's a great question. See what anyone else likes. It might be something else entirely. I might be the only crazy person who genuinely likes avocado toast. I don't know. At one point in my life, people treated it as like an ironic pick. You'd be like, haha, I like breakfast food. Oh, yes, I would order the avocado toast. And then everyone would laugh in the room. That's not true for me right now. I'm like, no, I really want that. Please. Thank you. Yes, it's delicious. I'll order two. It's silly, but regardless, it's my favorite thing right now, so I've been on a big kick about it. And why did I want to talk about it? Great question. Let's play Monster Train instead. Ah, yes, it looks completely broken because of me playing modded content. Anyway, so our previous run, which brought us up to 262 wins on the series, was a very early Capricious Reflection. A nice thing about this is it gave me a chance to kind of what is the turn of phrase here? Put your money where your mouth is, right? So basically you're gambling on the thing that you claimed you'd be good at. And I did a good job, I think. We won with the run. I think Capricious Reflection in general is something you need to adapt the way you experience and play the game in order to do a good job with it. And I think we did a great job here. It was a no restore, but yet we played Awoken Hollow strategy. We ended up with Root Seeds plus Tethys, of course. We had, what was it, an Animus of Will with Multi-Strike inside of it. Actually, no, it was the Animus of Will Infusion in a Nameless Siren with Multi-Strike, and then we had a Battlestone on it. And there was a Multi-Strike Endless Titan Sentry? Ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. So that's just absurd. But regardless, we made it past. A lot of Permafrost in the run with Titan's Claws. It was pretty cool. Today we are moving on to Umbra. Let me actually just verify this real quick and make sure I'm not completely off base. But yeah, so this looks accurate to me, correct? I had to make sure I wasn't accidentally on some other champion. And yeah, so we'll go ahead and play some Umbra and see what the game shows us today. It's always kind of, things get better once you're playing Penumbra when you're compared to Tethys, but Umbra as a clan is weaker than Stygian, so which one do I really think is worse? It's a great question. I don't actually know, but anyway, let's go ahead and get in on this. As always, do like, comment, subscribe if you haven't already. Those things are cool and neat, and all the cool people are doing them or something like that. So let's play some Monster Train and see what we get today. Clicking the button. Yes. All right, hope you're all doing well today. I'm doing okay, nothing too crazy to report. Been vibing on a number of like side things. I was about to call them side projects, but they're not related to the channel. They're just things I'm working on. And I'm very excited about making a new character for D&D lately, which is fun. Been really enjoying that campaign. I'm actually going to be temporarily retiring the character I currently play, which is a monk. Which is great. The character's awesome. I just feel like there's a good story arc for a little bit of diversity, so that's going to be exciting. So I'm working a little bit on that and some other fun things, but yeah, it's all good stuff. So let's go ahead and play some Monster Train. Hopefully you're having a great one. Today we are Default Umbra, Exile, Hellhorned. We are facing Dazed Talos, Rage Arcus, Sap Seraph, and Umbra Assault, Welder Helper, Ember Cache. Nothing particularly outstanding here. I appreciate having a ping at least. It's something, even if it's not the one I want necessarily. We do have good morsel generation for the moment, at least. Ember Cache is fine. I don't hate it. Welder Helper could be relevant. We'll see. It's hard to predict if that's going to be good or not, but we'll see. It's at least a decent card in a vacuum, so... Temples today are on 3, 4, 5, and 8. At least we have something in the late game. We have a removal dupe on Magic side on 8, which is exciting. Another removal dupe on 7. No Shop competes with a Steel with Cave. It's fair enough. A No Steel Ring 6 with Money in the Middle, Removal, Trinket Shop. There is a Magic Shop as well with Cave. Both sides are pretty fine here. Nothing remarkable to call out. Removal Magic Shop Horde is very strong on 5 if we can use it. There is a kind of weak Steel Shop, but if we need it, right? I mean, it is what it is. Third removal dupe with a Hellhorn Banner on 4. If we can leverage these... Things I'm thinking of here might be something like a plus 30, plus 10 in Piercing Vent or something like that would be a great target to just Hell Vent every time we see it, right? So something we should keep in mind if we can generate a monster card like that. If we can't, we'll do what we have to do and maybe go the other route. Noting, however, there is a lack of steel on 4 and another lack of steel on 6. Today we did not get denied. We have double steals in the early game as a result. A lot of Umbra banners, unfortunately, but there are Hellhorn banners for us to play with if we want. They're in kind of weird positions. Steel shops are all the Umbra banners. That's the problem, right? Maybe we'll get a unit draft or something that makes up for it, but we'll see. Resonant Shard, Improved Firebox. Improved Firebox potentially has the biggest upside with something intrinsic and then being able to drop that on turn one. Resonant Shard requires we actually find Rage, but it's pretty likely we see something, right? It's Hellhorned after all. I think I'm going to go with the Resonant Shard. It is... Both of these are perspective, right? Improved Firebox potentially enables turn one like Demon Fiend or something, but I don't feel like that's that impressive of a pick right now. So let's just take the Resonant Shard. It has higher upsides. We'll be okay. Glutton or Monstrous. Today it is Monstrous, always. I will look at the Horde here. We have kind of the reach we want. 9x2s are a risk, right? Big risk, but we could potentially trample through is an option. Ashes of the Fallen, we will be clicking here, even though Mindjax and Mark of a Champion are both good. Mark of a Champion especially is very good with Penumbra on Monstrous line, but there's no way we skip the Ashes out of that gate like that, so... Gathered Clergy, we should be fine to take this. It spikes, it's all good. We'll have some pings, but we'll be able to do some work with, these Queen Zimplings, right? Especially because they get the double Ashes. I sometimes look at that and I'm like, oh yeah, I forgot that was so ridiculous. They're actually cracked, right? Take the Shade Splitter. I'll take some health upstairs, yeah. Take another Shade Splitter here. I'm not going to toss that Ember Cache right now. It doesn't really matter. Looking for... What? Yeah, here you go. Just Queen Zimpling it up, and you just absolutely crush, which is great. I'll take Ember Morsel. I'll take Welder Helper. This lets me attack 3 times and clear the floor, which is cool, so that's nice. Great. Ping one of these front fellows out. Take some damage upstairs. I will honestly play Welder Helper at bottom. Actually, he straight up clears the clergyman in sort of a ridiculous fashion. It changes almost nothing to play the other one this way, which is strange but funny. Let's see what's in here. I'll save. Yeah, we'll just put this downstairs. It doesn't add a lot, but it's fine. We easy win this. We clear this just simply because Penumbra hasn't been fought yet, and we absolutely crush here, right? I'm gonna go ahead and ping out like this. I'll take the lifesteal upstairs, and I think we're going to chill. We actually do 48 damage on mid-floor just because there's so much health. It's fun. Ashes of the Fallen really does some crazy stuff. We win easily. Straightforward. We get everything. We take no damage. We get the trial. It's good. Immortal Trade Mind Collapse, I think, is a good pickup because I don't like Antumbra Assault. Space Prism, however, with Intrinsic means I don't have to take space for Penumbra, which is nice. I should really consider that. There's a good chance I see it, right? We have a couple rings where we might run into it. I don't think Mind Collapse is that important. If I hit a 10 in piercing or even just a plus 10 and Tumbra Assault's fine. Immortal Trade's very good, but I don't think it's as... I mean, it's good, right? It is good. Is the Immortal Trade better? I have a lot of armor generation that might end up being in my line with the Welder Helpers. Let's take the Space Prism. I think you could talk me into the... what's it called? The Immortal Trade there. Anyway, I'm not going to take another Welder Helper. We do not have a Fledgling Imp, sadly. I will just grab the Ritual because it is some rage for my Rage Relic. Where am I going? Hellhorn Banner? Merchant of Magic tossing a -1/-1 here would be pretty nice. I do like that. What do we do otherwise? What would you do with a holdover is the problem, right? Nothing. But what would I do with an Umbra banner? Also, nothing. The Hellhorn banner is better. I mean, it's like if I see an Umbra banner, it's like Alloyed Construct, maybe. And if I see that, fine. Okay, great. Then it's Multi-Strike or some options open up. But all these other things, like what am I going to do? Crucible Warden, Crucible Collector, Morsel Maker, Morsel Master, Shadow Eater. None of these are attractive options. So let's go look at the Magic Shop because it's the lesser of two bad choices, right? Double stack is an option here. Railbeater is something. I think Railbeater is a pretty good pick here. I like Horned Warrior, but I think if I were going to pick a nothing unit here and then find multi-strike later, I would rather it to be Railbeater than anything else. Takes the rage very well. Let's go ahead and grab Railbeater. It's fine. I'll take the Horde in the middle, yes. Scorching Restraints is nice, although Split Anvil does suddenly make this 3-cost ritual look pretty tempting, as is. I'm going to be playing a lot of units, though. Scorching Restraints has immediate synergy with Resonant Shard, which is nice. Scorching Restraints is a little low value, but it does provide some immediate burst that I appreciate. Vapor Funnel is also an option, but I do have some Trample I can work with here, so... I think all of these are fine. This doesn't really ring out to me as a big Split Anvil gameplay, right? I don't feel like that's fantastic here. I can certainly work around it and make it do something. Part of the challenge I'm looking at is I'm thinking -1/-1 on Ritual. I guess you could double stack -1 it, keep it at 3, and then chill. It's actually pretty darn good, huh? Because there's a double stack in that shop. Sure, I'll do it. Split Anvil, and then we will simply double stack -1 the ritual here. And that's a pretty potent grab. Okay, a 20 consume, only really valid on the Antumbra Assault. Not bad to do. Genuinely, it's okay to burn one of these. I'll actually burn one of these. Maybe 10 and piercing the other one if we see it. We move on, it's fine. That's an acceptable route thanks to this. Take this unit draft. I would be interested in a Horned Warrior here. Some other good options as well. So if we go Penumbra downstairs and then toss the Queen's Impling in, we clear the floor, which is fantastic. We get the Shade Splitter into Railbeater up top. Seems good. Right. First order of business, let's take a... I kind of want to do a ping, so let's go ahead and toss... Actually, let's toss Welder Helper bottom. This seems pretty decent. And then we can... I'm going to take the consume on... Actually, yeah, I'm going to take consume bottom floor for the morsels. We'll toss the Impling middle for Collector, and then I'll play both these morsels upstairs. It's fine. We don't do a great job clearing here, but that's okay. We can do Ritual, which lets me play Morsel Activity here, which I appreciate. We're doing a lot of damage upstairs, but I'm not really cleaving in any appreciable way, which is a bummer. Yeah, alright, so here's the thought. What if I instead go Welder Helper bottom floor? Man, he comes close to winning this, doesn't he? We're going to at least go Queen's Impling into Train Steward upstairs to get the back guy under 40. Or rather, so he's only doing 12 to me, which is a huge bummer. There might have been a way through this. Yeah, there might have been a way to avoid that 12. Not really sure, but not a huge fan of it. It's fine, right? It's fine. Yeah, we win with the imp. It's a bummer taking that 12 there, but the upgrades didn't really give us a ton of options. Mind Collapse, there's another Space Prism. Okay, fair enough. Packed Morsels. Don't think I'm going that route. Mind Collapse would be not terrible. I will grab the Mind Collapse. There's ways this can work out in my favor. It's a good versatile split anvil card is the main driver here, so we'll take that. I will grab Fledgling Imp here because double summons and the rage trigger. Excuse me, is that Shadow Siege? Why are you here, champ? I do not believe you are an appropriate unit for this run. You're funny looking, though. I don't have a great target. If I had Horned Warrior right now, I might genuinely do this. What's coming up? Umbra Banner? I guess I could go to the Hellhorned Banner and gamble on it. Only really Horned Warrior benefits from this, though. Otherwise, there's no good targets. Can't really predict that I'm going to see Shadow Siege, but he's pretty good if you can use him. I don't think so. I'm skipping here, I think, and we're going left. It's a bummer not seeing the Horned Warrior, but that's okay. I want to see an Endless. Would be great. Yeah, cool. Endless Rage Imp. Fantastic. We can do Endless Rage Imp, or we could do Endless Welder Helper. Kind of an interesting option. Think about that for a moment. Let's see what this Umbra Banner is. Warden, Shadow Eater, all garbage, as expected. What do we get today? Intrinsic on the Space Prism is good. I do like it. Plus 30. Not bad on a Mind Collapse. Infusion-wise, I'm leaning towards Imp on Welder Helper. So what you could do is I could take... There's something interesting here that's actually quite potent in that I can use armor plus rage scaling to buff Penumbra? If I take another Space Relic, right? Or dupe the Space Prism, you can create something really potent here. He becomes very defensive. It is winning with our current setup because we have the Ashes and the Resonant Shard. That's just so much damage gain. Penumbra solos everything. The challenge is killing him. Or rather, killing the Imp. Right? Killing the Imp is the challenge. Tons of survivability, though. It works easily on the Divinity because it sweeps, right? It's great. It does all the hard work for me. And then that's fantastic. It's just how do you win every other combat, right? You can't. The problem is I killed one Antumbra Assault. Not that I think that's bad. The other one is fine, but Mind Collapse only targets enemies. Huh. Well, which one gets the Endless, then? Fledgling Imp's infusion is easier. Welder Helper's infusion has AoE armor, which is good and is better. Right, think about this. Let's go ahead and open this up so you can see it. It gives him 21 health to tank with. You've run into the same problem. The difference is that you can play the Welder Helper in front, right? It's true. Yeah, you certainly can, and that tanks as well. I actually think it's safer to go this route, because then you can use it to chump block, and it's still valid through the mid-game because of the intrinsic Space Prism, and we can always pivot once we've seen other things. So let's go Endless into Fledgling Imp, and because this is so powerful, it is certainly correct to do the infusion now, right? I think so anyway. Welder Helper into this. This is a very powerful unit. This is, it's going to have 21 health. It's going to be very tanky for the early and mid game. And that's going to have to be okay. Yeah, it's going to have to be okay. Do I plus 30 Mind Collapse? Maybe. It's not bad. It's not my ideal choice here. You could always plus 30 the Antumbra Assault and then you can still pop this guy, even if he doesn't die. It's actually not a bad call. It's unbelievable, but I am going to click it. 80 shards walking into ring 2 is a little spiced out, but we'll see. Or ring 3, we'll see. Oh, neat. Railforger's Hammer actually super enables this without having to take space. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. Frozen Nostalgia. Interesting. It makes not many cards very good. Yeah, we'll just take the hammer. That's pretty good. Extra space and the space prism means we can actually do that line anyway. Now, unfortunately, I can't reroll this and afford anything, but the Endless is a really good pickup regardless, so I'm happy about this. And we'll kind of just chill and move on. The biggest risk here is, of course, not getting the imp killed enough. So we'll be on the lookout for anything that murders imps, pretty much. Now, I think we should shoot an enemy here, play Morsel, Space Prism, Penumbra, Railbeater here. And we may as well pop these next fellas too. Yeah, alright, fine. Okay, decent ordering. I'll just put a Queen Zimpling in front here, which is fine. I will play the Mind Collapse at 2, which makes all of the rest of these cards free, which I appreciate. Not that I need this morsel for anything, so we'll kind of let it ride. All right. Okay, so the Ritual is Big Brain. The Welder Helper is huge, though. I want to get him in play, so we'll do that first, even though he becomes 31 health because of the double effect. Whoops, I guess. That's okay. Manages to push 20 through. That's pretty impressive. Okay, top floor is clear. We're going to be suffering from how in the world do I actually clear this nonsense out pretty quickly. We managed to do a pretty good job here, at least. Rage on Trample Buddy is fine and good. Well, we managed to only take 5 damage, and the imp still lives, which is ridiculous, if I'm being honest with you. So that's fun. Sure, sure, great, wonderful. Can't even kill my imp for me, good grief. Now, we managed to get rid of it eventually, but it is still pretty bad, so fine. Better to actually put this Train Steward in front on middle, manages to push through. We'll get some guys shot downstairs, it's fine. Okay, we managed to be able to play the Imp again, which is something. Draw some cards, sure, sure, draw some cards. Play the Imp mid-floor here. They actually push huge damage numbers here. We can freely go ahead and Ritual upstairs. Not that I think I probably could have won on bottom floor playing the double stack down there, but it doesn't really matter to me. Take 5 damage and win the combat. Cool, big numbers. All it takes is just being able to play the lad and you're all right. Transcend Imp is good to take. Being clear, I think it's a good addition to the run, no matter what you do. Cool, plus if I see another Endless, we can go completely ballistic with a Queen Zimpling. Alloyed Construct. I really don't want this guy. I think we're going to the right removal dupe. We'll look at the Hellhorn banner. I don't know. I mean, there's only a magic shop competing, which is fine. I do want to look for another Endless now that I have a Tia. Tia plus Queen Zimpling blows up the world. These units, man, Umbra, not it. Not it today. I'd rather just make Penumbra huge. Card draw? I actually think Ember might genuinely be the correct pick with so many expensive options. I need to remove Shade Splitters. They're bad. I do not need space. I'm going to grab Ember here. There's pretty much no world that I don't suffer just a little bit from like a turn with the Welder Helper and the Ritual of Battle in it. So I want to make that viable. We'll go to the right. Looking for Horned Warrior here. Yes, Horned Warrior is active. Amazing news. Another Intrinsic is always fun. Go over 100 here. A little scary, I suppose. I actually think the cuts here, by the way, are Shade Splitters. They are in my way on the redraws in a very nasty way. Train Stewards I can at least play out. We're looking to make Penumbra big. which is great. I'm also looking here to do Horned Warriors infusion right away, I think. For sure, this provides a lot of value. It puts us over 100 pack shards, and I am about to dupe again as well, which is kind of ridiculous. Now, what do you dupe here is a good question. That is a great question, in fact. Argument for the Antumbra Assault, because I could at least kill my own stupid imp, which is funny, and it's a decent ping. Is there anything good? I could give it another plus 30 and make it a 60 damage ping and make two copies of that. It feels almost irresponsible, but... does 60 damage really do anything? After you hit 30, it's like, what is the next one is, what, 75, I think? At least when you're ignoring piercing, because I don't have that. If I'm going to dupe it, there's value in... I don't know. I don't feel like adding pack shards really does anything here. The 10 is fine because I can shoot the imp. This, I think, is good. 33 is enough because he has 1 plus 10 plus 20, which is 31 health. So we do crack that. I think we're just going to do this. Maybe we'll give these things minus ones later or something. It's fine. 115 pack shards. We're good. We don't have to push any harder here. Aggressive amulet is scary. It's a great way of dying, actually, right? It's possible. We're strong, but draw orders can put us in a big, bad situation. A lot of those back guys get upgraded. We're in a dicey situation. Let's go ahead and hit this off here. We have enough money to reroll for a steel shop, and there's money in the middle, so... now, fortunately, we actually have a really good roll here. Popping an enemy, and then we're able to do Penumbra, bottom floor, with a Welder Helper... great. And then I can do space upstairs. I don't actually know where the... I think I'm going to put the space prism upstairs. We can probably do some get some value out of that. I don't need it downstairs here. Okay, again, what we do here is we want to play imps upstairs. These are good. One more of these, and I feel respected. Like, I want to save this one health, but the way we do this now is I think we get to play this imp out still. Ping, ping. So if I'm going to play the imp out, it goes middle. It may seem weird, but you'll see why. No, we play at bottom. No, we don't. Play up middle. Yeah, I had to think about who I want to deal with. We ping upstairs. This is fine. And then we take out the bottom guy. We toss the miner up top. The health actually isn't a benefit here, but that's okay. They attack because it's the armor that's keeping him afloat. So that's good. So we're just going to go ahead and play a Transcend Imp upstairs 100%. And that's going to be fine, I think. We're going to go ahead and toss double taps here and Transcend Imp upstairs, which is a lot of scaling. I'll put the Ember Cache in, save this imp for another turn. It does put us in a little bit of a dicey situation upstairs, but we do get the Welder Helper, which I'll play and clears the floor. Great work. Bottom floor, not so great. We do want to play out a Train Steward if we can, but getting the rage down is good. We can then toss Ritual of Battle here. We get to play some Shade Splitters. It's fine. It goes 109, 109. I can accept one damage here by pinging in the middle, and then we toss the Excavator down to ping the back fella. And I think we're good there then. Whew, okay, we make it through. It's nice. Get some excavated embers. I don't really know how much value that's going to add. I'd like to not take these curses. I could actually ping the imp out, though. Here's what we can do. I'm going to go ahead and shoot my own imp and let the guy ride. We'll go magma, magma upstairs. Take the shade splitter. Play that bottom as well. and chill. This works out in my favor, I think. And then we just simply play Imp again, and we crush here. The Transcend Imp actually doing great work, so fantastic. We win, for sure. Good. We're getting great mileage out of Railbeater here. Feeling good about that. Engine upgrade, I already took Ember, it's fine. Prism Retrieval maybe can fish out something decent. It obviously could hit some garbage too, but it basically replaces itself. I think we'll grab it here. It's a good addition. There's possibly a world where that tutors well. Tiresome Climb, I think we have to pick. I'm morally obliged. Impish Scholar, worth considering. It only brings back Antumbra Assault. Cycles, maybe some Ember Caches, Prism Retrieval, Space Prisms. I mean, it goes crazy a bit with the Transcend Imp, but I'm just going to take Tiresome Climb and chill, I think. I think that's it. We're going to go hunt some Steel Shot because another Endless is a game winner here. And we have enough cash to hunt. Quick. I don't have an issue with Quick on this. One of the nice things about Railbeater is we have 30 health baked into him, so I don't need defense. I can afford this. It's pretty cheap. It's got enough cash. I'll take the Quick, sure. It does kind of hurt the whole, oh no, the Imp must die, but I have double Antumbra Assaults specifically for this. We hit a multi-strike. Yeah, we're loaded. All right, this guy is cracked right now. Triple hitting, 30 health, effectively. Feeling good about that. Spell Chain. I don't know what I want to spell Chain. I do wish to purge a Shade Splitter. Yes, that's good. Infusion-wise, we don't have to commit on this one for a bit, huh? It's true. I get some removal dupes. What would my removal dupe situation be like? It's funny because I actually do think that duping the Antumbra Assault would be cool, but I'd like to upgrade it first. So I'm kind of leaning towards Magic Shop coming up, give them minus ones, then maybe we dupe it on Fring 7. As silly as that sounds. Now, what we could do instead is go look for the Endless on Ring 7 and then dupe it with the Magic Shop on Ring 8. It's kind of a decent loadout. It avoids us taking a random Pyre Remains, and we get both types of shops in the later parts of the game. I think that should be good. Reminder, we are on Train of Thought, so I don't have to go crazy. We also have a Ring 8 Temple if I want to do that final round there. That final round being that final infusion. I think we're chilling. I'm okay with this. I guess I could pay 60 gold for a removal, but I do kind of want to go where? Magic Shop coming up. It comes with double money. I'm just going to buy a cut here. We're going to burn a Shade Splitter. Yes. Shade Splitters hurt my redraws more than Train Stewards do. It's one of the rare instances where I think cutting the Shade Splitter first is correct. This is free money. I'm always willing to make this trade. It's fine with me. Just the Railbeater pops top floor, so that's cool. Fun. Yeah, great. So we'll go ahead and play Penumbra downstairs. He's just gonna completely slam dunk these guys. And that's great. I'll play Railbeater up top, doing fine. He pops the mall. Now hear me out. Fledgling Imp downstairs? I pop in middle, we actually guarantee it, right? It's true. Alright, now what I could do is bottom floor ping out. Now, I would like to train. I'd like to Transcend Imp here. So I think the play is this Tia is not as good as one would hope, genuinely. I think we'll actually chill on this. I'm going to go ahead and ping middle. 25 I have no concern with, and I would like money. Let's go ahead and just pop a guy downstairs real quick. That pushes numbers through. We can pop the guy middle. It doesn't trade very well, but it gets him out of the deck. The Quick is doing good work here, which I like. I feel in control of this combat, which is great. Let's keep loading up Penumbra here. Fantastic. This is exceptional, right? Then we can buff upstairs with the ritual. We'll just burn out the prism retrieval and we're chilling. He's doing 70 by 3. Top floor is in a good position. Meanwhile, our imp is cycling well. So, seems good to me, right? I can pop mid floor pretty well as... Yeah, get rid of that. Like that for me. Good. Pop, pop, pop. We do clear correctly. I'm going to toss the welder helper upstairs. Actually, 70 armor seems necessary here. I can feed this train steward and we're okay with it. How's top floor looking? Now... top floor's okay. Would really like to get rage upstairs, but we don't have a good venue for it. So let's continue raging downstairs here, and then we'll play a shade splitter up top. Seems okay to me. We're clearing the floor. He almost just straight up wins downstairs, which is pretty awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and farm out some stats up top, play out the shade splitter to burn it. We'll toss Queen's Impling down, get rid of the stuff for the redraw. I actually will just shoot the boss. Yeah, sure. We're in a good position. Mr. Penumbra is doing a great job, actually. All right, cool. So we're actually super fine now. We just go ahead and... yeah, this is going to be dumb. You play the ritual up top. We get a free tiresome climb. We're going to play the cards out because they're dumb and I want you to see them, but behold my might. We go ahead and we toss down the fledgling imp, and then we stick a transcend imp in play. And this transcend imp completely converts this floor into the Doomslayer. I could have also tossed down the Queen's Impling, but it doesn't matter. We win anyway. So, I mean, really, this is what Heavenslayer Railbeater, basically, is the name of the game. Engine upgrade, excavation eruption. It's not bad. I don't think it helps what I would need, though, which is shoot my imp and clear floors and draw fast. So skip here. Impressive is a kill imp card. Do I need this? Yes. I'm going to click it. I think kill imp card is more important. We're going to go left. Yep. I already talked about this. Magic shop. I want to make some of these things free. That's important. Free Antumbra Assault is good. 20 consume... it's not a bad idea to 20 consume the Mind Collapse here, right? It's not terrible. It's not good. I'd still prefer Tendon Piercing for this. I think we're going to chill. There is an opportunity to see it. I'm going to reroll that. Double stack. Tiresome Climb could be very large, which I like. Makes it quite efficient, which I appreciate. I'll make it quite efficient. Yeah, I'm good with that. 4 days. The minus one here is going into... I was going to say if I see a holdover, it's holdover impressive, right? But we'll make the Antumbra Assault free for now. I think this is the right choice. I'll save the Tiresome Climbs slot for a possible minus two later, which is good. Buy a removal, maybe? Let's look in the cave and see what we see. Strength Stone, I do not mind. That is an overstack for Railbeater, which is good, right? Quick multi and now this. Sure, great. Seems fine to me. I don't think I need the other ones there for any reason, so we're fine. I'm going to grab the cash real fast. I actually do think I want to buy a removal, which I think is... is it just the last Shade Splitter? It might be. After Shade Splitter, it's finally Trained Stewards. Yeah, all right, goodbye. Shade Splitter, I don't need them. All right, cool. 20 consume is still an option on the table for the Mind Collapse, but I think saving for the possibility of a Tendon Piercing would be cool. Though I guess that could go into Impressive, too. So, it's also an option. I don't really want a 20 consume Mind Collapse. This card seems decent. I have only like one option for it later, though. If I see a Tendon Piercing, it's the right pick for it, though. All right, we'll hold on to it for now. I'm not going to 20 consume it. I'm thinking. You can tell I'm thinking. I might actually 20 consume it because I can Tendon Piercing Impressive. This is going to be fine. Yeah, we'll get rid of it. I'm really cleaning up the deck is the idea behind this. Now we will go left here. There is double money, so I could purchase a removal now. I might as well. We have enough cash to reroll and look for that Endless. Now we cut a Train Steward. These are now in my way. Cool. pretty aggressive so far, but feeling good about it. Very powerful opener, lets us do some really potent kind of game manipulation here. This is going to be a Space Prism downstairs angle. We'll play a Penumbra, and then we will toss Fledgling Imp down. Big numbers. We get the Railbeater up top, which is fine. We'll burn a Train Steward middle. Great. It's a pretty decent clear on middle. I think I will just Tiresome Climb the boss up at this point. I don't get to play out the Queen's Implings, but that's okay. Because more importantly, this is Days That Stacks. 14 health. What I want to do is ping the middle friend here, which perfectly kills there. We'll play some morsels up top. I will shoot the 9 damage fella on middle, and we'll take some more morsels here. Good rolls, honestly. Cool. I'm a fan. Play out a Train Steward just to get rid of it. We'll toss Fledgling Imp downstairs. Gets perfectly slain. Draw. Sure, we'll put down this. Seems reasonable. Play it in front because the cleave will get it. Perfect. Good. Great. In fact, we clear a floor. Excellent news. Cool. And now you can kind of see the goal here, which is we get to play Fledgling Imp, then shoot it. And then we Transcend Imp. Because this will be enough to win, for sure. And now he's chilling on the floor, which is actually great for us, right? Him chilling is a big help, so that's fantastic. And now we do, like, yeah, literally 936 damage, seems decent. And we'll go ahead and toss the ritual upstairs, push big number, play out Ember Cash. I think we crush. I mean, we easily win the boss fight now. We auto kill him, right? Is actually the good story about it. So let's Tiresome Climb the boss, and then we get to blast middle, and then we get to shoot here, and we're chilling. Top floor, obviously killing. And I think we're golden, right? Because I get to go. I could have actually played this Fledgling Imp twice if I had wanted to, but I think that's okay. We shoot it here. I'll play out some rando imp. Seems good. Just to get rid of it. It's fine. I may as well push numbers. So sure. Fine. Do you win, brother? You come kind of close, which is a little interesting. Eh? 200 damage? Nah, it's fine. We'll just put this upstairs. It doesn't matter. You play the Fledgling Imp in middle, bottom. Yeah, oh wow, actually. Hold up, never mind. We do win. We win on bottom floor. That's where we're at here. Great job. Go Penumbra. So we're pretty strong, I think, is the way that I would describe that. One Horn's Tome viable, actually. Because I am reliant already on Fragile. So I don't mind this one way or the other. It's a little expensive, admittedly. I have 4 Ember. I go to a magic shop, I could make it playable. That's true. Now, the thing is it's decent, but I'm just going to be duping the Railbeater on Ring 8 anyway, so I think an Alloy might pay out more. It's a little lower investment required, and it's just a big sack of health that I like. Spike is not terrible, but it's also not good. We'll take the Alloy. I think that's the correct choice. I would like to draw more cards, please. Yes, draw more. We're going to go left because there's plenty of money and an Endless wins this run in a disgusting fashion. It's the last opportunity for it. This dupe could be cool, but we have 3 cards that cut here. Removals are nice, I'll admit. How important is Endless Transcendent, actually? The answer is not very... It's not very important. We're winning anyway. Let's just go to the right, yeah? Let's just go to the right. It's fine. This is like huge value. Being able to cut the double stewards here is great. Big value. Big cleanup. We'll go Forge. I'm gonna go Monstrous 3 here because I would like Penumbra to start at bigger numbers, and we can give him the Space Prism and throw that imp in front of him for a while until we need to put it elsewhere. So this works out great. Yeah, do it. take the cash. Dupe-wise, a lot of choices, actually. We could dupe our lad now, which is fun to consider. Sure, we'll put him on the floor now. Seems fine. We potentially could pivot the space prism to top floor and have double, triple Railbeaters. It's very fast kills, admittedly. As long as we can draw quick enough to shoot our own guy out, somehow. I definitely think this dupe now is the correct pick for this upcoming combat. There's no further upgrades he can get. We'll take it now. Yeah, sure. Move on from here. It's pretty potent, right? And that gives us a more flexible dupe coming up. I don't think Ancient Hate scares me. Not a chance. If I lose, it's not going to be because they have Spell Shield, that's for sure. Okay. We're going to still do Space Prism downstairs here. Play our lad. I'll toss a Queen Zimpling in front, sure. We go double Railbeaters up top. I will play the Imp out on middle, just so I don't have to redraw it later. It's a good opener. This is a very good opener. We do get the Ritual out front, which I really appreciate, but most importantly, the Mind Collapse on the guy upstairs lets me play this Imp still, which was part of the reason I did it. Now, because, I could keep Penumbra among the living, possibly. Or I could buff upstairs. I think buffing upstairs is good because look how big, scary this floor is. Yeah, let's go Fledgling Imp here. We're going to toss the Impressive. And then most importantly, we're going to draw. It draws from the bottom, right. So we play this downstairs, which does save Penumbra. Congrats, he lives. Want to put some armor on him? Sure. Seems good. Draws from the bottom. It's always a weird thing with prism retrievals and stuff like that. Okay. This is good. This is good. Now, top floor is clearing, so let's pump up Penumbra a little bit then. Wow, I can't believe he dies to the... Yeah, okay, fair enough. I was going to say, dang, he's dying to something crazy. I think the right way to do this is to ascend in the back here. And he lives. We get to Ember Cache. Now, I could actually pop something out here, sort of weirdly enough. Could save Penumbra some health, maybe. Doesn't really matter, right? I guess I'm just gonna shoot a dude. That seems fine. We'll toss some damage stats upstairs. Fine. Okay, bottom floor, he's okay, which is cool. I can buff him and then go nuts upstairs, which seems like an obvious pick. So we'll do that. Now, I know what you're thinking. Hey, this guy in back is living, but he's got enough days that I also do not care. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and put down the Welder Helper first, so that then when I drop this Transcend Imp, it goes completely ballistic as well. Good. Great. A good turn. This guy walks up. I don't care. Penumbra dies. Again, I do not care. Now, I do need to... Unfortunately, I have ruined my ability to fit anything on this floor, so that's a bit of a bummer. We're going to go ahead and play out a dude. I'm going to draw cards here, see what I hit. Get this guy shot. I don't care. I should work on killing the Welder Helper here at this point. We'll buff the guy in the back. I will play the Fledgling Imp. This floor actually lives incredibly. All right, great. Draw. Huh. We win in one, right? Yeah, obviously. I was thinking, I'm like, I can ascend and then clear middle, and then he has three turns, and it's honestly correct to do this, right? There's no reason not to. We can go and then pop here, which is great, and then we shoot the imp upstairs, which gives space for it. Which lets me drop in other imp here, and we're chilling. Don't play anything middle. Great. He walks up 3 days, just press end turn. Or we ascend him, and we lose. Whoops. No, we're fine. Okay, great. I feel good about the state of this run right now. Another Ember Cache, Grovel, Gem Trove, unnecessary. Skip it. Imp in a Box, Impolate. Impolate's not bad, 120. I don't really care about this, though, right? I don't think this does anything for me. I could get some rando imps for my Transcend Imp, but I'm not playing into Endless Transcend Imp, so I don't care. We're just going to skip here and play the game we're meant to play, pretty much. We go left. It is the strongest option by far. Totally. Look in the temple first, see what we get. Minus two. I would love for my Tiresome Climb to cost one. And we get a tendon piercing at long last, which I'm just going to put into that impressive like I said I would. Very cool. Great. Now it kills the front line. Look at that. 100 and piercing. We love 100 and piercing in this household. Forever Flame is, obvious, I think. One of the most obvious purchases I could make in this run. It makes so many cards free. Wow. Vortex. I mean, at this point, I don't even care about the Train Steward, really. But I'm still going to remove it because it slows my initial draws down at this point. But really, we're lightning fast, right? Woof. Yeah, absolutely. You got a holdover for me? You do. I mean, this is free real estate, right? Cool. Feeling pretty good about the state of this run, I would say. 20 consume, unnecessary, minus ones. What do you even do here? It's a great question. Every unit is free, so the prism retrieval is fully pointless. Wow. All right. I think the easy answer here is to dupe Railbeater and go really heckin' fast and then let Penumbra just pass away. There's no reason for it. We can go seven space, six of them are from the Railbeaters. One is an imp that gets shot every turn. Eventually you drop Transcend Imp and you're golden. Dupe. Easy. We hit 200, right? So I think the other removal is, gosh, what's the worst card in the deck? Consume Antumbra Assault, unironically. All of my cards are either really good or consume. Or are units which consume. So we're just going to cut the worst consume card. Okay. I still have a lot of cash. Rationing scales? Hammered chest plates? No, I actually think the 33 damage is kind of an important threshold here. So I'm going to spin that. Pyrestone housing, that's funny. Worn Grindstone, I guess? What do you remove if I buy something? The Mind Collapse? Hilariously, I actually think the answer to that is yes. We've got our deck down to such a good state. I think it is actually just Worn Grindstone and a removal. Crazy. But yeah, I think it's correct. The Worn Grindstone does something, right? It makes these numbers a little bigger, which is fine. Great, in fact. Sure, and then I remove this Mind Collapse. Is there really nothing worse? No, there's not. Okay. Sure, there's nothing worse. Great, $20. I can't afford the minus one, but I don't care. 23 cards left. I can take some stuff in here. Got an infusion I wanted to do, maybe? I don't know. I could endless some other imp, but again, I don't care. I actually think I can do this infusion comfortably. And do imp into imp just for the removal here because we are so powerful. We just go 225 down to 22 cards and we chill. Okay, Monster Train, let's do it. I feel good about this run. We should crush Divinity and Seraph very fast here. Feels good. Feels good. Play Monster Train, win game. Cool. We'll go Penumbra, and he'll just kind of punch and get punched. We're going to blast on mid-floor here, which is fine. Space Prism and double Railbeater up top. Seems good. Hold on to Tia for now. We're going to lose Penumbra right quick, and that's going to have to be okay. We get Railbeater, we get to Ritual in front, and then we'll Alloy in front and Blast on middle. It's fine, I'm not afraid. Oh no, he'll come upstairs. We have a really good chance of drawing well here. We do not draw well here, but that's okay, right? I have no real problems with the state of how this ended. So let's, first order of business, I actually think we do want to pop some guys middle here. Play out the imp on middle. See if we can't bait Seraph a bit. Yeah, we actually super can. And then you put the welder helper on bottom. And we ascend one of these fellows up. Then we're chilling, I think. He should have to go middle here. Good. Yeah, and now we chill. Now it's simply fledgling imp. Blast him. Play the queen's impling. Prism retrieval, which hits Tia, which is unfortunately not one I wanted, but it's fine. Well, elevator. Yeah, here you go. Free big numbers. It's not transcend imp yet. We chill. We do push some numbers through to the boss, though. So that's good. Cool. We go welder helper. Impressive. Draw. Which I guess we go welder helper and shoot him again. Then we draw him back, which is a pretty decent turn. Yeah. Cool. I am quite a fan of this. We sack on middle. It's fine. Easy floor top cleared. Easy. We're going to do a billion damage to the boss here. Cool. Goal is impressive. We also wish to ping one of these dudes to get more damage through. Then we're going to drop Transcend Imp in for massive gains. Whew. Buddy, boy, really? We win the combat. Game is absolutely free. Alright, sure, that's a pretty relentless kill here. Tia getting the last smack. 5-turn boss rush, sure, seems good. That's pretty quick, and it's about as quick as I expect Divinity to go. Divinity never even leaves the floor, so that'll be nice. We're quite powerful, by the way. The early ashes, and then we have an endless imp. It's pretty much golden. Bottom floor. He swings, which is honestly the single best thing he could do. Imp first. Great. Railbeater down. We'll toss him the armor. Leave Tia in. We're still waiting for that daze whenever it comes. We don't see it. We're going to go ahead and double drop. It's a pretty good chance we draw something we want here, right? I think we... It's a bit of a gamble, right? Playing them here is a bit of a risk. Welder Helper, Fledgling Imp. All three imps, Prism Retrieval, or Tiresome Climb are good. So... really, you're looking, there's three easy win cards here out of 10. Theoretically, we could miss them. But consider, if we miss everything, the worst possible pick would be every card except for Welder Helper, Queen's Impling, Fledgling Imp, and Tiresome Climb. Right? We're always putting a morsel upstairs so it takes this Ember Drain, but... basically, the thought I'm having here, and something to keep in mind, is what is the worst draw here? I don't want to lose this run suddenly because of hubris. So, the worst draw misses Fledgling Imp, Welder Helper, Tiresome Climb, and another Imp. Now, that does guarantee me a Prism Retrieval, right? Because if we see all three Imps, then we could be missing something else, but then we would have the Prism Retrieval, which fishes one of the other two. So, we're fine, right? Welder Helper saves the man in front. Sure. Fine. I think we don't play second or third Railbeaters here out of risk mitigation. Because if we end up with the Welder Helper but not one of the AoE solutions, we're a little bit out. But our redraws are going to be very fast here, right? Like, I have no cards, so I'm going to easily see my Railbeaters again before it matters. Thanks to Penumbra buying me a turn, essentially. So... I think we do not play them, and we press end turn. It hedges against the worst possible card draw here. All right, we actually got the absolute best possible card draw here. So we are, or not the best, we didn't get the really good one, but Welder Helper goes in back, fantastic. Fledgling Imp goes in front, great. We're gonna shoot the Fledgling Imp. Great work, go team. We blast Middleman here, it's good. Just send it on him. We'll play out the Ember Cache. We'll tank some stuff, some morsels upstairs. Okay. Great. Now, we should be okay for the moment. Right. Okay, so I think we do wish to... The Tiresome Climb is high value. It's unclear what Prism Retrieval will hit, but playing it at zero cost is a viable option. So, first pick is tap out the Ritual. Go off floor, see what we roll. It's a Railbeater. This is honestly acceptable. We're going to play Queen's Impling in front first. We're definitely going to Tiresome Climb the boss here, I think. There's pretty much no way I'd do it. Maybe I get rid of the Shade Wings instead and accept, what, like 5 to the Pyre? It's not a bad roll. I think we can actually do better if I go Railbeater first here. Right, that actually pops this out. Then we can go Fledgling Imp in front. Then we can Tiresome Climb the boss. And we shoot out the Welder Helper, right? The neat thing about this, then, is we play the Queen's Impling middle to clobber that guy, even though it costs me armor. Okay. We're in an acceptable state. This is pretty good. I want to shoot out Antumbra Assault here on my own guy. I realize that hurts me. But check it. We then get the Railbeater in. Good. Great. You hit the over here. And we play Fledgling Imp middle to get him shot. Play out these morsels. They do not matter. And then we toss Transcend Imp upstairs to huge chain gun our run into victory laps levels. Good, great, we did it. Cool, and now I just kill the... Next time I can kill that imp, we're golden. Look, we can do it. Great, I blast my imp. Fantastic. We get Fledgling Imp down. Cool. We shoot the imp. We draw a card. We play the imp. We shoot the imp. We send the boss. We toss in... Well, I guess you may as well put damage in, sure. Sack some morsels, some other floor. We're golden. Great work. I guess that morsel stole melee weakness, but I also kind of don't care, so whatever. It's fine. Blast this guy. We'll ping one of them, which does guarantee us the kill. Great job. We got it. So, interesting having to navigate a challenging turn because the Divinity was doing so much damage that he two-shots my Railbeaters. So, something to keep in mind there. It's easy to get a little bit risky. And run into situations where you have to play smart like that. Still, I think we had the tools to answer this. Everything in my run was about drawing fast enough to hit those important cards. So even though they were all in my bottom ring, I hedged against the worst possible draw, and we crushed, right? 3-turn boss rush on Divinity, no big deal. Great stuff. This run is all about Railbeater, feels good. The quick is really high value here, nothing ever swings into me. Multi-strike, obviously nice. Horned Warrior... Love me a Horned Warrior infused into Railbeater run. It's honestly just great. Fantastic, right? Early Ashes, early Resonant Shard, just play into these. I actually really like the 7 space floor as well with the intrinsic space prism plus the rail hammer, or rail forger's hammer rather. It's a very nice touch. The rest of this, I mean, Forever Flame just makes everything free. A lot of good value there. And honestly, tons of value out of Split Anvil based on the way we played it. when I say tons, I don't actually mean a lot. It wasn't like I was holding over a 3-cost card or something, but there were multiple turns where this ritual or something like the, where is it, Prism Retrieval was putting out just enough to put me over, so. Also, all those removals in the end ended up mattering in a big way. Every single card we removed was important to guarantee that final turn that we had, so pretty pleased with that. I really don't have a ton else to say. I think that we kind of figured this run out and did a good job of it. We found an early direction and played into it. Impressive did a lot of work here. Big fan. Kill Imp every turn. Great work. Honestly, Antumbra Assault deserves a lot of credit here. Just straight up. This was my how do I kill my Imp solution for a majority of the run, which was cool. So, cool. Great. I don't have much else to add, so fantastic. That brings us up to 263 wins in the series. Wonderful work. Go team. And I'll let you go there. So, hey, thanks a lot for watching this. I really appreciate your time. As always, you can give the video a like if you want. You can subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. And stay tuned for what's next. Take care, folks.